have a multiple rich number of traditions here in the room. Properly speaking, theologically, Jesus Christ is the Word of God, and we get that from John 1:14, the Word became flesh and pitched its tent among us, dwelt among us. That's now widely accepted. I know not everyone will agree. I don't expect anyone to agree with anything I'm saying. But I just want to cite two authorities for that. Karl Barth and C.S. Lewis, somewhat different minds and strategies, as examples of people who would argue that Jesus Christ is the Word of God. Find my C.S. Lewis quote. It is Christ himself, not the Bible, who is the true Word of God. The Bible read in the right spirit, with the guidance of good teachers, will bring us to him. When it becomes really necessary, that is for our spiritual life, not for controversy or curiosity to know whether a particular passage is rightly translated or is myth, but of course myth specially chosen by God from among countless myths to carry a spiritual truth, or history, we shall no doubt be guided to the right answer, but we must not use the Bible, our fathers too often did, as a sort of encyclopedia out of which texts isolated from their context and read without attention to the whole nature and purport of the books in which they occur can be taken for use as weapons. C.S. Lewis's approach, as he often likes to do, a binary approach. It's not this, it's this. I'm more comfortable with Karl Barth's approach, and you'll hear me do this right now, which is a sort of a series of concentric circles. In the center is the idea that Jesus Christ is the Word of God. That's the primary sense of the expression Word of God. But by extension, many of us would use the expression the Word of God to relate to the scriptures that describe Jesus Christ. Among those of us who accept one Bible, two Testaments, some of us would see Jesus Christ in the Christian Old Testament, while others would not. Some traditions within the church, I think especially the Lutheran tradition, expect to hear the Word of God in sermons preached from the Bible, while other traditions would not expect to hear that. And some traditions, and here I think of Pentecostal and charismatic traditions, within the church expect to hear the Word of God in prophecy during a service of worship, while others would not. How is the Word of God in Scripture related to the Word of God made flesh in Jesus Christ? Quick answer number one. The prophetic tradition describes how the Word of the Lord came to a specific person who then began to speak in the name of the Lord or to speak a word of the Lord to a specific situation. Jesus stands within that prophetic tradition. Quick answer number two. Jesus, as a Jewish man of the first century, would have known most of the scriptures of Israel by heart. He would have been formed by them. For Christians, the scriptures that Jesus knew and loved are as important as the scriptures written about Jesus. And just as a reminder, you all know this, we have no scriptures from Jesus, unlike Paul. We have letters of Paul. A more complex answer is to focus on Jesus Christ, the Word of God, and the wisdom